folks, welcome back to the channel. This video is going to be a bit about the experience of felling this tree. The reason why he was being cut is, and I'll get Debbie to do a few shots, we have oak regeneration right here, and she'll get a shot of the two, three other oak.
Other little guys coming up in the same area, yep.
And then we'll talk about exactly what went on here.
There's one little guy right beside the stump. There's another little guy, 5-6 feet off to the left. And there's a bigger one that's in there.
It's a pink ribbon.
With the ribbon and the brush already protecting him.
And then another one just over there.
Just over there where, Mr. Hickey?
8 feet to the left.
Of the big guy?
Another big guy.
Oh, I see him. Also brushed. In there.
Okay, so this was a multi-stem red maple. Obviously, or likely, a result of stump sprouting of previous tree cut, and then you get all the... So these two stems here were quite easy. They were all leaning in this direction, and so I just cut them, leaving this bigger one. Now he was leaning this way.
So the opposite direction.
Right. So as you can see, by the time I did my hinge, the tree, I perhaps should have done it a bit smaller, but there wasn't much room. So as I was cutting in and getting to here, you can see the chain, the tree sat down on the saw. And I did have a wedge in, but unfortunately, the wedge did not have enough power and enough distance to actually lift the tree up off the chainsaw. So what I did was, and I don't know if this is my own invention, whether it's something I saw on YouTube and can no longer remember. Anyhow, this worked for me, and maybe it might work for you, but this is experience, not expertise.
What, you're going to put the tree back together?
I'm putting the tree back together, gluing them in. Okay, so there he was. Original condition, almost. So, he's sitting down on my chainsaw. So what I did, I took my other saw.
Oh, so you had both saws with you.
Oh yes, always. I did a bore cut in about as far as I figured the wedge would be.
So that's the bore cut is where your wedge is stuck in now?
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Because once you cut this, it's cut down below and it's cut here. There's no strength in those fibers. So I put a wedge in, whacked it in, and it started to lift the tree. And I thought I was just about out of space and not able to go much further when boom, over it went. And as you can see, it's not a lot. You can see where these fibers have been pushed out. So if you have your chainsaw jammed and you can't find any place to get a wedge in around it, this trick may help you out. I kept about, oh, that's probably about an inch and a half above the chainsaw. I wanted to be careful that I didn't make the two collide and and damage both blades.
And lose both.
Or whatever. Now all I have to do is figure out how to get my wedge back.
How to get the wedge back out.
One moment, and I'll get some tools.
Not yet.
There he is. Ta-da! Why won't he knock? Anyhow, you can see basically.
Yeah, he's stuck out.
What it needs to take.
Yep.
You got to make sure that your cut is at least wide enough for your wedge to go in, and even if you went all the way through and out through your hinge, that's probably not a big problem.
You almost dropped that on that little oak seedling.
I did.
So this is just up the hill from the maple, I was going to say tree, stump. Michael's cleaning out a little bit of the regen, some birch, the raspberries he's not worried about, because in here, this is an oak, but this is a burr oak, rather than all our others are red oak. So he's a one of in the woodlot. We did actually plant him. He did have a partner in crime that didn't survive. Michael's just cleaning a little bit of the overgrowth. Watch out for that other little oak there, guy. Because we did discover after the burr oak that a little red oak came up right in behind him. So now we have two oak, only a couple feet apart. Right, there's the red. And all kinds of raspberry bushes.
Yeah, I don't think there's any serious competitors here now.
Anything tree is gone.
Right.
Raspberry bushes are fine. Actually, leaving them there might be a good thing, because then the deer won't see the little oak guys.
Yeah.
So you don't want to clean it out too much.
Well, I think these guys would survive browsing now. But still better if they don't get browned.
If they don't have to do that. Yeah, I ate a couple of raspberries while I was waiting for you. Yum.
I'm sure you did.
Anyway, because the oak were up here, that's why Michael had to fell the maple tree in the direction that he did, because he didn't want it to fall on these little guys.
Part of the problem with when you're doing this kind of work is you have to work with directional felling, typically, because you just got stuff that you just don't want to damage, and that's nice. That's a nice problem to have. It beats the heck out of a fir thicket where you don't care
where it can fall anywhere.
But at the same time, you know, it's a nasty thing to happen. You know, that you forget, which is partly why we put ribbons and markers around trees, is to try and make sure that I don't forget that they're around and drop something on them.
Drop a big white spruce on top of them.
Yeah, I mean, the idea is to help Mother Nature, not discourage her in any way. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Catch you on the next one.
Yeah.
Anyhow, take care, stay safe, and see you later.
Catch you next time, guys.